Hi everyone, this is quite a dark little space. Oh, that's even worse. I'm just in a van heading back from Federated Farmers with the Minister of Agriculture, where we just, alongside industry, made an announcement on what we're going to do to try and, in the long term, eradicate Mycoplasma bovis from New Zealand. We had three options. One was eradication. One was phased long-term management, just accept that it's here. And one was to do nothing. Just to give you an idea of the kinds of things that we needed to consider. Mycoplasma bovis is a disease that other countries do have. In fact, only New Zealand and Norway doesn't. Once it is within your national herd, though, it does have an impact on productivity. It manifests through things like mastitis, arthritis, pneumonia, and it can cause, for instance, calves to have swelling in their joints and a number of other issues. It is an animal welfare issue. That's why it impacts on animal productivity. That's why, when we looked at all the numbers, our best estimate was that it would cost roughly $1.3 billion if we just decided to manage the disease in the long term. However, the option of phased eradication would cost us closer to $886 million. That is the cost of compensating farmers who might be affected, and also includes some production losses. So we've decided that we've got one shot to try and eradicate this from our national herd and that we should take it. To give you a sense of what that means, though, those farms that might have an infected herd, we estimate that might be over a 10-year period, roughly 192 farms out of about 25,000. They will be asked to cull their herds. That means about 126, roughly 1,000 cows over a 10-year period. Now, for those farmers, losing an entire herd is devastating, and I want to acknowledge that and how hard that will be. We do, however, every year, as a part of dairy farming in New Zealand, about a million cows on dairy farms will be culled as part of dairy farming. So that gives you a bit of perspective on the scale. That's not to diminish how difficult it will be for farmers who lose their herd. Those farms who do have their herds depopulated, they will be compensated. We hope that will happen between a 4 and 10 day period, with full compensation within 2 weeks. They keep their farm clear for 60 days, and then they can repopulate their farm, continue farming again with the certainty that they do not have bovis on their farm. For those who do not have any restricted movements or anything like that, they continue on farming as per usual. We ask them to keep good track of their animals and where they are moving. We do believe it's possible, but we will keep monitoring this situation alongside the industry, who made the decision with us today, and a group of experts gave us the advice that this was possible, and that's why we're doing it. I do just want to make this final point. This is deciding that we are going to live with Mycoplasma bovis has an effect on animals as well. It means we are choosing for calves to experience a pretty rough start to life in some cases. It means that we are choosing for animals to live with animal welfare issues, because there is no cure for it. And so not acting means a portion of our national herd will get sick, and we would be choosing for that to happen. 99% of farms do not have this, and we don't want those 99% of farms to get it. And so that's why we are making this decision. And it is a tough one. Like I say, we'll keep working together. We'll keep monitoring how our eradication plan is going. But we have eradicated diseases before, and he's hoping that we will be able to do it again. Thanks for tuning in. I'll keep you updated. And I'm heading south tomorrow to see a few affected farmers, and I will stay in touch. Cheers.